KSBW weather with Jim Vanderzwan.
Winter's here, Christmas just about hours away, literally, and we're still waiting on something in the way of wintry weather around here. Lots of parts of the country are either cold or covered in snow and ice or both. But around here, nothing but high clouds, no precip of any consequence all the way up to Vancouver Island. So what about storms? Well, there are none on the horizon right now. And we are a little on the dry side, needless to say. Normally, our rain year is a fiscal year that starts on the 1st of July, runs around the year to the end of June. But because of the nature of, we don't get much rain in the summer. But from the calendar year, by the end of this year, we will likely have, overall, around California, the driest on record since 1917. We just didn't have much rain, remember, last January, February, March, April, and not much, of course, the first half of this winter. Second half might make up for a little of it. We'll see what happens. Nothing on the horizon, though, as I mentioned. Meanwhile, chilly in the nighttime hours, 30s and 40s. Daytime highs, 71 Boulder Creek and Santa Cruz, 68 in Van Alman, 78 in Scotts Valley. Didn't last long, but it's on the books. 69 in Marina. We got 72 in Seaside and Carmel by the Sea, 77 in Carmel Valley, another 72 in Big Sur. That's warmer than you see in July when the fog's in. 75 Salinas. Got, well, give or take a degree from that all the way up and down the Salinas Valley. A little nippy this morning. We expected that. Greenfield, King City, close to the frost point. Same for Gilroy. A little bit warmer elsewhere in Santa Clara Valley. 68 to about 72 did the trick today. And that's better than, well, even the Central Valley. Mostly 60s there. Barely made 71 in Redding. 50 up at Tahoe. Way too warm for this time of year. 80 in Van Nuys. 81 in Palm Springs. It's all because of the offshore flow. Once you get on the other side of the Sierra Nevada, it's a different deal, though. 40 Boise. 54 in a mile high city. Sometimes altitude can actually help because cold air sinks down. 24 in St. Louis, just about double that down in Dallas, and that's cool. 17 Chicago, 41 in New York. Right now it is really getting cold. 15 in Chicago is only 45 Dallas. Denver's gone out of the 50s, or below freezing already. Feels more like 20, feels like 1 in Chicago. Bismarck, 18. Cold air is moving out to the Great Lakes. That cold front is off the Atlantic. The precip is settling down outside of scattered snow showers. Of course, what fell is either frozen or white or both. And now more snow coming across the plains. Not a major blizzard, mind you, but enough to keep things fairly active and a white Christmas for a lot of people. That continues north of Chicago tomorrow into the Great Lakes states. The cold air is not going anywhere fast, that's for sure. A little bit of precip on the top end of this high pressure ridge, but nothing wet for us. Looks pretty scary on the satellite. Hawaiian Islands in the sun there, and of course they'll get the stars before too long. Most of these high clouds just dissipate in the sinking air of high pressure. This system out here, too far west and too far north to get to us, but the winds generated by that are generating some pretty good swells, so a little caution along the water starting tomorrow afternoon. Meanwhile, the Futurecast model says ridge hangs around, then moves in, and we might see a few high clouds as this cutoff low comes by, but not enough energy there to make any precipitation. And right behind it, here's your high pressure, and your offshore flow is going to continue through the weekend and probably to New Year's Eve before we see anything wet. Winds fairly light, mostly offshore. That warms things up rather nicely. The cold air stays on the other side of the hill. We have the, well, some of the warmest temperatures in the whole country to look forward to for the next couple of days. So, lacking rain, we're going to have a real nice, easy travel time for this Christmas holiday, that's for sure. Right on into the weekend, looks like. 60s ought to do it in the Bay Area at the top end of the day with 40s overnight. That's pretty comfy. We'll try for a few 70s, and a lot of this just depends on how long that east wind lingers in your house. When it does, it could even pump up a couple of more degrees, which puts it well above normal and maybe a few records. We only tied a couple today in Salinas and Gilroy, but you never know. It won't be anything super hot, but nonetheless, 70s around the Monterey Peninsula, like I say, that's sometimes warmer than what we see in the summer months. Overnight low is still pretty cool, but above the frost point by and large, so no big worries there as well. And tonight we'll go with clear and cool then, with light southeast winds, about 3 to 6 miles an hour. Tomorrow, of course, Christmas. Winds not more than 10 miles an hour, good part of the day southeast, sunny and warm. And for December, upper 60s, low 70s, mid 70s, that's warm. Next day could actually bump up a degree or two before the ridge finally breaks down. Yeah, we'll start seeing some clouds Friday night, Saturday. That'll help keep things out of the freezer for now. It dries out a little bit Monday and Tuesday. Daytime, clear for the next three. High clouds coming in Friday, a little bit more on Saturday, but it's back to partly cloudy by Sunday. None of these clouds, unfortunately, right now look like they'll bring us anything wet. So last weekend of the year, going to be on dry side, but we'll see what happens, Dan.
Yeah.
We still we still have time, 4 or 5 months.
People would sure like to be here.
Yeah. You know? Yeah, no kidding. I mean, and you're sitting somewhere in Maine, you know, with ice and snow on the ground and no power.
Electricity,
so, you know, this is pretty good.
Okay.